Howdy ding dong doodly guys, welcome back to Let's Play Persona 3 The Answer. With me, TapersCrazy, where we last left off, we fought our way through, was it Cositus? I think it was Cositus. Essentially, the abyss of time is what I'm trying to say. So we fought our way through, fought the second boss, which went pretty well. So today we're just going to finish off Cositus as well. I don't want to worry about fusing personas for the moment being. Probably next episode or a few episodes. I think we're doing okay at the moment with the ones we've got. Because if I just check through them, details, look. We've got fire. We've got wind. We've got wind again. We've got lightning. We've got some physical. We've got physical attacks, essentially. We've got darkness. We've got ice. So yeah, and we've got light as well, so we've pretty much got all the main elements covered for this period of the game. It's just essentially eventually what we're going to do is we're going to start fusing personas and get more powerful spells. So what I'm going to do in this episode is finishing this particular area, so I'll just be doing what I usually do, just cutting through the floors, and then I'll cut back to you. Well, I need to go to the next floor first to see what happens, and then go back to you as I start the encountering new enemies, or if any cutscenes happen.
That black shadow! Strange reaction I sensed when you got to this floor. Oh, sorry, I'm not detecting any strong presences right now. But the shadows on this floor seem to be stronger than before. Please be careful if you go on.
Alright, what's the worst that can happen? Let's just get stuck in, shall we? Okay, some strange enemies here. Let's just, check those. For the balance, I'm not entirely sure what they would be weak against, so let me switch to a more powerful persona. What does Empisa do? Let's switch to Megaru, and we'll change the tactics of the team to act freely at the moment, and then once we start seeing what we're capable of, we'll change it up. So they're weak against wind, that's fantastic. Okay, that spring of life was clutch in the boss battle. I mean, we didn't need to keep healing Junpei as much. Right, okay, so. So I'm gonna hit them with Argy, so I need Orpheus out to deal with these guys. Orpheus. Has he got Aguilar yet, actually? He does. But I don't want to waste Aguilar on these guys. I'm not sure how many floors I need to go. I want to save my SP. In case I come across anything a bit more crazy. Save the SP for the clutch saves, you know? That's not cool. I can sense your determination. Yeah, shuffle time. I could do with that persona actually, so. Oh, I couldn't tell you. I got the second mess thing, so. Okay. Orpheus is leveled up, so it's Orpheus gonna get. Oh, it gets Tarunda. Cool. Don't really use support spells as much in this game, to be honest. I should probably do that. Anyway, let's keep going. Hey, we leveled up, so we're now level 32, I think. Excellent. What else did seismic change? Empusa! Finally, a single target Garu spell. That was killing me in that fight, man. Excellent. Oh, Malin sexy dance. Good job, Narcissus. Just don't let that robe drop, you know. You're more than a flower on your head that's standing up. Oh, shit. Oh, no, spinning heads. It's like Mumbo's Mountain from Banjo-Kazooie. Anyway, we know that guy's weakness, so I'll switch to Orpheus just to knock that thing down, so it's not bothering us. Yeah, we'll use an Aguilar to see how much damage we can do. Perfect. Can I really use Aguilar now? So. Let's see what fire does to this. I assume it's not weak given that the other one is. Blocks it, okay. Weak against wind. Okay, that's good. So we've got plenty of wind and we've got plenty of fire. Yeah, finish that thing off before it kills us. So I'm trying to remember the tiers of damaging spells in this game. I think it's your standards, your Argies, your Garus, your Bufus, then it goes your Lars. So Garola, Aguilau, Bufula. And then it goes your Dine, so like Agi Dine, Bufu Dine, Garu Dine. Why did I switch? Oh, we'll use my Garu. It's fine, we'll knock it down. There we go. Okay. I'm not sure how I'm doing for Persona count at the minute. Oh well. Well, after experience as well, so I did get Sarasvati from the other fight, so I'm not sure how many I can carry at any one time. Ooh, no, no, no. So let's just keep going. Oh no! A maniacal buck! Persona, what are we weak against? These two are weak against wind, aren't they? Okay, so I'll switch to my single target, which is Empusar, and knock these guys down. Just so I know, these guys are knocked down and got a shit ton of damage done to them. And then we'll try Garrola on the book. I assume it might have a block or repel on it. Given the way this formation's played out, but what else can we do, yo? Damn it. Cool. I'm waiting for the scan on the other enemy. It's taking a while, actually, to get his scan done. So I'll try a Bufu actually, because I've got some personas which can do single target ice spells. Who can do ice? Sarasvati can, so let's try Bufula. On you! I'm suspecting fire then. Oh shit, instant kill. Fantastic. Darkness. Well, shit. I do have a Mudo spell, I think, so I could try that. Why are you using some support spells? Don't do that. Right, let's see what darkness personas I've got. Mudo. There we go. Hopefully this will hit. It's very hard to hit, though. Miss. Shit. Okay, yeah, just I'll keep trying Mudo. These guys can just pump damage into it. In fact, I'll probably be dead by the time he gets to my next turn. Yes, perfect. That's a difficult one, because Mudo and Hammer are instant kills, and their hit rate's very low, so... Right, I'm on floor 13.
The path seems to end again a little further down. You're almost there. Hang in there.
Okay, so pretty close then, yeah? I want to get the items, but these shadows are being a bit of a pain. Like, I don't have to deal with a shadow to get an item, you know? Shit. Run! Alright, we're now level 33. We're actually leveling up pretty decently through here, so... that's kind of good. Oh, here we go!
It looks like a dead end. We'll head over there now. Why don't you see if you can find anything else?
Anything else? All we've done is found a big door. Where will it lead us?
Well, Sergeant?
To school.
You can go. Looks like a pretty routine accident.
Oh, it must be the police station. I thought it was a school staff room for a moment there.
Hey, kid. Sorry I took so long. Says here your name's Ken Amada, is that right? Yeah, well, jeez. Sorry about what happened to your mom.
Is this right after his parents?
But she gave her life to save you from the collapse.
Oh my god! This game's gonna start cutting deep!
Anyway, I gotta take your statement, yeah? You're a witness, after all.
If I told you what happened, would you believe me?
Yeah, of course I would, huh? Helping people out is our job.
My mom was murdered.
What?
Around midnight, I got up to use the bathroom, and I heard voices by the door. I looked and saw this teenager holding his head and yelling.
Wait, you're saying he did it? But the whole house was crushed.
There was this shining kind of horse monster, and it came right out of him.
Turned into a shadow.
It roared, and my mom and my house were...
Oh, was it? I'm trying to remember back. I'm so hazy about the past of this game, but it's either it was someone turned into a shadow, because that's what happened to people with... isn't that what happened to people that essentially was out of coffins during the midnight, however, turned into shadows or something? Or was it a member of Strega?
Oh, a monster, huh? Yeah, well, yeah, there's no way that actually happened.
Is this guy for real? Is this kid telling this story and he's being a bit nonchalant about it? His mum's just sort of died, you know?
Oh, I shouldn't laugh. I know, sometimes after a traumatic incident like this, people can...
I'm not lying! And I really saw it!
Look, it was an accident. Plain and simple. A drunk driver crashed his car into your house.
And the entire building collapsed. Come on, that sounds more stupid.
What? A car crash?
We've already found the car and what's left of the driver. We just need an account of the accident now.
That's a lie! You're making that up!
I know that's what you think, but, it's true.
Sergeant, can you come out here?
It'd be right there.
Wait! I really saw it!
Look, I'm sorry for your loss. I have to go, but well, hope things get better.
So, is... Because the police don't really know what happened, are they... I know it's a car and everything, but are they essentially planting evidence so they don't look stupid and incompetent? That's not the police's job. The police's job is to keep the peace and find truth in things that have gone awry, isn't it? I don't know.
Liar. You said you'd believe me. I can't trust any adults. So I'll find him myself.
Oh, it's all coming back to me now. It wasn't a member of Strega. It was Akihiko's friend, wasn't it?
The door's gone.
He stopped taking his... because they used to take medicine to inhibit the persona's essential outbursts, essentially. Stop the persona from taking control of them. But... I can't remember his name, and I feel really bad that I can't remember his name. It was the one with the beanie hat and the big red jacket. But I get the feeling that what happened was, that was the night he lost control of his persona. Accidentally killed Ken's mother. It's all coming back to me now. I think this is the case. I think that's the story that happened there. And that's the day that he left this group of people here. Akihiko and Mitsuru. So, shit, man. He's delving on really deep scars there.
But the first door didn't disappear. It just opened up to a new place. Never mind that. That was... That brings back memories. I thought of lots of ways to search for the culprit, but I couldn't manage any of them alone. I kept wondering why the culprit had special powers and I didn't. I wonder if that's what led me to start experiencing the dark hour since that day.
Ken.
My family must have been the ones who put the accident cover-up in place.
So she had a hand in it as well. Well, her family had a hand in it as well.
I'm sorry for that.
Hey, Metis! What was that about?
It's the Abyss of Time. Put two and two together. I think it's just showing doors to the past. In particular, the past of the characters here.
What about? Oh, I see. Apparently, events that not everyone was involved in can only be watched. That's something new.
That's not what I meant. Why do we see such a painful memory?
Huh? How would I know? It's your past.
You better not be hiding anything.
How would I benefit from that? I'm only speculating, but I think the door reflects the mind of those who enter it. It's the same reason we found a place to get supplies, and why we were able to return directly back. Right now, you wish to erase the Abyss of Time as soon as possible, and make it out alive, right? If so, then although what's inside the doors seems unrelated to our situation, we see it for a reason. Maybe you should think hard about what the reason might be instead of wasting time accusing me.
Damn.
What did you say?
Shit, girl got fire.
It's all right. What she's saying might be true.
Ken.
Yeah, Ken's gone through a lot of development since then. He's come to terms with his mother's death, and I think he actually forgave the guy that did it at the end, so he's, you know, he's resolved his feelings in a kind of a way. I'm not sure what would happen if digging them back up again, what that would cause him to do, but Ken's a really grown-up kid, you know. You've seen shit.
Actually, I've been wondering about all of that lately. Things weren't perfect, but it seemed more straightforward and pure back then when I was fighting. We don't get that kind of passion by just going to school every day. Sanada-san, you've dedicated yourself to boxing again recently, right? Isn't that because you don't want to lose the feeling you used to have? Of course, that could just be my own way of seeing it.
Maybe you're right. Maybe I do feel just like I did.
Let's not talk like that. There's no use bringing up the past. Don't you remember our entire reason for risking everything? If we don't keep our eyes forward, it was all a waste of time.
Yukari.
Let's go.
For what reason did the vision of a friend's past suddenly appear? You decided to return to the lounge. Shit, man, this game's going crackers on me. It's gonna start making me cry and shit.
Alright, I think I'm done searching for clues. Yamagishi will pick up the search from here. From this point on, I'll be trying the main investigation as well. Everyone's finally together now. If you need my help, don't hesitate to call me.
Yeah, Mitsuru was a badass when she joined your party in the main game. She's like a really powerful ice spell user, so Bufu's essentially. She really plugged the gap in once I got her in the main game, but anyway. So what I'm going to do is Not sure what I really need to do. I want to do a bit of grinding if I can. Because I know that this game does entail the odd bit of grinding. I think whilst the balance is pretty good in terms of your general level up as you go through places, I'd rather be sure. I want to get to at least level 35 before I keep going on. So I'll do that outside of episodes. And next episode we'll continue on to the Abyss of Time. So thanks for watching this, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video.